Hello students, this is Swati Agrawal. Today we are going to learn a new chapter in science, that is chapter number 11, The Human Eye and the Colorful World. So students, under this chapter we are going to discuss about the human eye. We will also discuss the human eye, how the human eye uses the light and enable us to see the objects around us. It has a lens in its structure. We will also learn what is the function of that lens in a human eye, how the lens is used in the spectacles correcting the defects of the vision. Under this chapter, we will also learn the ideas to study some of the optical phenomena in nature, and in the end, we will also discuss about the rainbow formation, splitting of the white light and the blue color of the sky. So, the students, the human eye is one of the most valuable and the sensitive sense organs. It enables us to see the wonderful world and the colors around us. On closing the eyes, we can identify the objects to some extent by their smell, taste, sound they make, or by touch. It is, however, impossible to identify the colors while closing the eyes. Thus, of all the sense organs, the human eye is the most significant one, as it enables us to see the beautiful, colorful world around us. Do you know that the eyes are located in the eye sockets in the skull, and the eyeballs is approximately spherical in shape with a diameter of about 2.3 centimeter. It has mainly the two layers that cover it, that is the scleroid and the choroid. So students, the function of the scleroid is that it is the outermost covering that consists of the white fibers, and its function is to protect the all parts of the eye. The function of the choroid is that it is the gray membrane which is attached to the choroid from the inner side. Its function is to darken the eye from the inside so that no internal reflection takes place. Apart from these layers, it consists of the many other parts, as you can see in the diagram in the picture. That is our cornea, retina, blind spot, lens, iris, pupil, ciliary muscles, optic nerve, etc. So these are some of the other layers apart from the scleroid and the choroid. So students, moving further, the human eye acts just like a camera. Its lens system forms an image on a light sensitive screen called the retina. Light enters the eye through a thin membrane called the cornea. It forms the transparent bulge on the front surface of the eyeball, as you have already seen in the figure. Most of the refraction for the light rays entering the eyes occurs at the outer surface of the cornea. The crystalline lens merely provides the finer adjustment of the focal length required to focus the objects at different distances on the retina. We find a structure called the iris behind the cornea. Iris is a dark muscular diaphragm that controls the size of the pupil. The pupil regulates and controls the amount of the light entering the eye. The eye lens forms an inverted real image of the object on the retina. Now, the students, the retina is a delicate membrane which is having the enormous number of the light sensitive cells. These light sensitive cells get activated upon the illumination and the generate electrical signals. And these signals are sent to the brain by the optic nerves. The brain interprets these signals and finally processes the information so that we perceive the objects as they are. So students, moving further, the eye lens is composed of a fibrous jelly-like material. Its curvature can be modified to some extent by the ciliary muscles. The change in the curvature of the eye lens can thus change its focal length. When the muscles are relaxed, the lens becomes thin. Thus, its focal length increases. This enables us to see the distant object clearly. When we are looking at objects closer to the eye, the ciliary muscles contract. This increases the curvature of the eye lens. The eye lens then becomes the thicker, which resulting the focal length of the eye lens decreases. This enables us to see the nearby objects very clearly. So students, the ability of the eye lens to adjust its focal length is called the accommodation. However, the focal length of the eye lens cannot be decreased below a certain minimum limit. Now students, have you ever tried a printed newspaper or any printed page by holding it very close to your eyes? Have you tried it reading a printed page? You will see or you will observe that the image being blurred, or you will feel a strain in your eyes. So student, to see an object comfortably, you must hold it at about the 25 centimeter from the eyes. So student, the minimum distance at which the objects can be seen most distinctly without the strain is called the least distance of distinct vision. It is also called the near point of the eye. For a young adult with the normal vision, the near point is about the 25 centimeter. The farthest point up to which the eye can see the objects clearly is called the far point of the eye. It is infinity for a normal eye. You may note that here a normal eye can see the objects clearly that are between the 25 centimeter and the infinity. Sometimes the crystalline lens of the people at the old age becomes the milky and the cloudy. This condition is called the cataract. This causes the partial or the complete loss of the vision. It is possible to restore the vision through a cataract surgery. Now students, moving on, let us discuss the defects of vision and their correction. Sometimes the eye may gradually lose its power of accommodation. In such conditions, the person cannot see the objects distinctly and comfortably. The vision becomes the blurred due to the refractive defects of the eye. There are mainly three common refractive defects of the vision. These are myopia or the nearsightedness, hypermetropia or the farsightedness, and the presbyopia. These defects can be corrected by the use of the suitable spherical lenses. Now we are going to discuss these defects and their correction in the brief. Now let us discuss about the myopia. Myopia is also known as the nearsightedness. A person with the myopia can see the nearby objects clearly but cannot see the distant objects clearly. A person with this defect has the far point nearer than the infinity. Such a person may see clearly up to a distance of a few meters. In a myopic eye, the image of a distant object is formed in front of the retina, as you can see in the figure, and not at the retina itself. So, this defect may arise due to the excessive curvature of the eye lens or the elongation of the eyeball. This defect can be corrected by using a concave lens of the suitable power. Illustration, you can see in the picture that by using the suitable power of the concave lens, this defect can be corrected. A concave lens of the suitable power will bring the image back onto the retina, and thus the defect will be corrected. Students, moving on, let us discuss the another type of the defect, that is the hypermetropia. Hypermetropia is also known as the farsightedness. A person with hypermetropia can see the distant objects clearly but cannot see the nearby objects clearly. That means it is just an opposite of the myopia. The near point for the person is farther away from the normal near point, that is the 25 centimeter. Such a person has to keep a reading material much beyond the 25 centimeter from the eye for the comfortable reading. This is because the light rays from a close by object are focused at a point behind the retina, as you can see in the following figure. Now, this defect arises either because of the focal length of the eye lens is too long or the eyeball has become the too small. Now, as you can see in the picture, that this defect can be corrected by using a convex lens of the appropriate power. Eyeglasses with the converging lenses provide the additional focusing power required for forming the image on the retina. So students, now let us discuss the next type of the defect, that is the presbyopia. So students, in the presbyopia, the power of accommodation of the eye usually decreases with the aging. For most people, the near point gradually recedes away. They find it difficult to see the nearby objects comfortably and distinctly without the corrective eyeglasses. This defect is called as the presbyopia. It arises due to the gradual weakening of the ciliary muscles and diminishing flexibility of the eye lenses. Sometimes a person may suffer from both myopia and hypermetropia. Such people often require the bifocal lenses. A common type of bifocal lenses consists of both the concave and the convex lenses. The upper portion consists of a concave lens and it facilitates the distant vision. The lower part is a convex lens. It facilitates the near vision. But students, these days it is possible to correct the refractive defects with the contact lenses or through the surgical interventions. So students, moving on, let us discuss the refraction of light through a prism. So before understanding this, let us discuss that what is a prism. So students, prism has the two triangular bases and the three rectangular lateral surfaces. The surfaces are inclined to each other. Now students, the angle between the two lateral faces is known as the angle of the prism. In the prism, the incident ray enters the prism, gets refracted, and it bends towards the normal. And when it moves out of the prism, it now bends away from the normal and forms the emergent ray, as you can see in the picture. The peculiar shape of the prism makes the emergent ray bend at an angle to the direction of the incident ray, and this angle formed is known as the angle of the deviation.